Now we're at the point where we're going to start writing our own CSS. You've used a little bit of CSS through the page properties, and that's okay to use, but what I don't like about it is it adds a little bit of extra code. So I want to teach you how to write your own CSS. Let's make sure we understand what CSS is. CSS is what controls the look of the page, not the content. The content goes in the body tags, and that's marked up with HTML. So in this one, for example, the CSS controls that the page we're on is red and the type of font and the font size and the margin that we have up here and the width of this and the background color here and the type of font and the font size for here and that there's an image here. All of that is done in the CSS. And the way that works is by targeting your HTML. So first, in the head, within the head tags, you have to write an opening tag which is called style type equals in quotes text slash CSS. All right, so we're going to use the code helpers to help us get all that in, but this is the opening part, and I'm right after the opening of my head tag or right after my title tag, which is also in the head tag. And then I have to close that with just a style tag. So I don't have to write all of this out, it just gets closed with a closing style tag. And again, I'm within the head tag. Then what we do within that, see, I'm in the style tags, I write an HTML tag, for example, an H1 tag, right? We have an H1 tag in our example that we're going to be working with. And I put an open curly bracket. And then within my open curly bracket and my closing curly bracket, I specify what it is I want to target. So for example, I want to put a margin of at the bottom of my H1 that is 0 pixels. And I'll talk about what this means exactly, but this also could have been a font size or a font color. All right, so after this is the way you target it. Anything that would be two words is hyphenated. And between what it is, the attribute that I'm trying to add or apply to my HTML, I have a colon, and then I put in the specific amount. So in this case, it's 0 and it's px for pixels and then a semicolon. If you are forgetting your semicolon or a closing bracket, it won't work. Or if you have all of this outside of your style tag, it won't work. All right, so let's jump over to Dreamweaver. I'm picking up where I left off on this intro to CSS page. And I'm here working in my code. I'll expand that, move the design view over a little. And I'm within my head tags. Right after my title tags, I'm going to start off with typing that in with style, and I can choose my code helper, space type equals text slash CSS. So I just start typing and then I use the code helpers. Now I have to put my closing bracket, that's right there, so that's the greater than sign. And then I'm going to come down a couple of lines and put my closing style tag. All right. And I pointed out before in another video, but under edit code, I can do apply source formatting and it will do all the alignments and stuff for you, which is kind of nice, except for I didn't want to bring that up. I want that to be down here. All right. So the first tag we're going to target is actually the body tag, which is not a tag that you've written. You haven't marked anything up with the body. The body is one of those that we put all of our content in, but we're going to target the body tag. And that is when we target the body tag, essentially we're targeting our entire page. So that's where we'd put our background color, for example. So I'm going to write body, open curly bracket. Dreamweaver gave me a closing curly bracket, and that's fine. I'm going to hit the enter to come down, and I'm going to start to type in background and choose background color. And I could choose one of these default colors, or I could click on the color picker and choose something. I'm just going to grab a color. I have to put in a semicolon, so it did not do that for me. Put in that semicolon, or else it won't work. And let's just click over here, and now I can see the result of that background color. So I applied it, it's in, I'm targeting my body tag. What else is part of the body? Well, I could choose a font type, and that would apply to all of my text. So to do that, I'm going to choose a font family. And notice this font family, they all come up in groups of three. And that's because if that person's computer doesn't have the first font loaded, then it would try for the second one. And if they don't have that font, then it would try for the next and so on and so forth. All right, so I'm just gonna grab a font and again, put in a semicolon. All right, so now everything on my page, whether it's a link, a heading one, a heading two, a heading three, or a list, everything has that font. So when I put a font family in the body tag, it applies to everything. If I want all of my different tags, my heading tag, my paragraph tag, to have different fonts, then instead I would apply a different CSS rule to those tags specifically. We'll do that as well. And now let's give it, let's see, a font color. So I'm going to make, oh, sorry, everything, to give it a font color, I'm just going to type in color. And so everything on the page will now be this color. So I'm just going to pick like dark slate gray, and I put in my semicolon, and I go over here. Don't really like the way that looks. I'm going to switch that to black. Okay, and now everything will be black. All right, it already was black, but so it just would get rid of any kind of default. Another thing I could do in my body tag is I could target the margins on the page. Currently, I don't have any margins, so I'm going to put a margin for the top of 100 pixels, and now that's going to move that down, and come down a line, I'm going to do the margin on the left also at 100 pixels. All right. And now if I want to see this page, view it on the web, I'm going to save it, Control S, or you can go up to File, Save, and go down to my little icon down here, the preview one, and choose a browser. If I hit F12 on my keyboard, that'll automatically open up in Firefox because that's my default browser. I'm going to switch it over to Chrome though. I want to see it in Chrome. And here it is. Okay, so that margin really helps. We will eventually talk about how to get your content into the middle of the page, but for right now, this is pretty good. Okay, so that's all we're going to target in for the body tag right now. And then in the next video, I'll go through targeting writing CSS for other tags.